Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel and let's speak about January 2019 PSVR games. Let's see what we're gonna play next month. Now Christmas is over, we received our presents and said, oh, thank you. As well as we ate tons of food and got fatter and of course chat some shit to the family. But now it's time to enjoy PSVR. Any of you got new PSVR for Christmas? If you do, please let me know in comment section. I like to hear those stories. But also make sure you can follow me on Twitter at PolishPaulVR, so don't forget. And now let's move on and quickly do January 2019 PSVR new games. And we're gonna start from Dreams Beta, the game that everyone waiting for. So the beta sign up starting on January the 4th. So this is just the signups. Once you sign up, the Media Molecule, the developers of the game, we look at it and gonna be like, he seems to be worthy, let's give him the beta. Some of people, including me, got the beta already if you was subscribed to Media Molecule newsletter. The beta do not have VR, but still worth applying for it, still worth checking out because there's a lot to take in the game. So if you get the beta, not only you'll be able to give some productive feedback, but also you'll be able to learn some of the mechanics of the game. VR mode will be in full release, not in the beta, but like I said, worth signing up. And on January the 8th, it looks like it's gonna be our first proper release, which is Megalith. This game's beta, actually it's ongoing now and people having tons of fun fighting with each other because it's an online game, player versus player, you playing as a hero and fighting other heroes in order to find out who is the best hero of them all. During the beta phase of this game, the game released some nice updates, some nice patches, so when Megalith releases on January the 8th, we can expect very nice polished game. I didn't check it out yet, but from people who played the beta, apparently the game is a lot of fun, so definitely something well worth looking forward to. Announced at E3 2017, 2 years later, finally Megalith will be with us. I love the art style of this game, looks beautiful, looking forward to it, so remember the date, January the 8th. Another game I want to talk about and possibly the biggest release of January is Ace Combat 7 releasing on January 18th. First of all, let me tell you, Ace Combat 7, no doubt about it, the game will be awesome and I definitely want to play it, but let me concentrate on VR mode, because VR mode only gonna be 3 missions and 4 airplanes, or aircrafts, shall I say, which you'll be able to play, as well as there will be airshow and free flight mode, and the developers said the VR mode will only last for around 3 hours. So if you're planning on buying the game just for VR mode, might be worth waiting for a sale, but if you plan on playing full game and then VR mode, then probably VR will be like a cherry on the cake. You're gonna eat that cake and say, nom, 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 that was nice, and then you're gonna see, fuck me, I forgot about cherry, let me put it on my eyes and play Ace Combat 7 in VR. The VR missions apparently are beautiful and apparently play great. They've been demoing the game on various events, people been having hands-on with the game, and even though VR mode is small, apparently it's really awesome. Another thing releasing on January 18th and this time for free, it's Kingdom Hearts VR Experience. It's meant to come out on December 25th in Japan, but then Square Enix decided that they're gonna release it on January 18th around the world for everyone. And when it releases on January 18th, it's only gonna be part 1, which gonna be like a music video showing you best moments from Kingdom Hearts franchise. You'll be able to see your favorite characters in virtual reality, just like they standing in front of you in real life. You're gonna see Donald Duke and say, oh my god, he's so handsome and I can see him, I want to quack at him. And also, of course, other characters. So that's gonna be part 1, January 18th. And in spring 2019, you'll be able to download part 2 to have full Kingdom Hearts VR experience. Nice to see that they're releasing it for free, very nice. On January 22nd, we get in Fisherman Tale, coming from Vertigo Games. They bring us Arizona Sunshine in past, but now they decided to publish something as well. And they're gonna publish, yes, Fisherman Tale. In this game, your task is to warn humanity about very angry, raging storm that approaching their way. So you sitting in your property, which is your lighthouse, that's where you live as a fisherman, and in order to warn the humans, you have to solve some puzzles. But puzzles in this game are kind of mind-bending, because you can see other fishermen around you, like there's a model of the exactly same lighthouse inside of your lighthouse, and inside that model of the lighthouse lives exactly same fisherman. You look through the window and you see him again. So you pass in objects from one to another. It's all weird, but also apparently very fun. And that's the games with release date confirmed, but there is some more games scheduled for January that don't have release date yet, but they will be definitely coming. So we're gonna talk about them now. Make sure you smack that like button, because it's very nice of you if you do so, and carry on watching. We're gonna start from Honor and Duty D-Day. So this will come in January. The developers are not sure about the release date for the game yet, but probably January, but definitely in January we're gonna have another beta for the game. The beta was ongoing through November and December. There will be one more in January, because they want to test tanks. And in those tanks you'll be able to ride them, of course, shoot them, as well as you'll be able to have some buddies inside your tank, so you can all team up together and do like Star Trek Bridge Crew in real time, fighting real people who play online. Sounds pretty cool. And of course other game modes will be there as well. And then after this beta there will be full release. And Honor and Duty D-Day is such a fun game. Supports aim controller, DualShock, move controllers, or all of them together. There's defend mode, battle royale mode, attack mode, player versus player mode. Just tons of different modes. Very fast action, tons and tons of comfort options, vehicles, tanks, everything. So looks pretty awesome. Another game coming out in January is Vertigo Home. So you might wonder, what is the meaning and what is the message? This is yet another trippy tunnel game, my guilty pleasures. I really like the Polybius, which has very nice trippy graphics and very nice trippy overall gaming experience. And also I liked Hex Tunnel. The ingredients for cool trippy tunnel game are simple. You need very nice snappy controls, a very very good soundtrack, original graphics and fast action. And Vertigo Home seems like it's got it all, so I definitely gonna look forward to it. Not the biggest game, but looks like a fun game. It's a port of mobile game, but it's completely rebuilt. Mobile game looks 10,000 times worse, looks completely different. They redone the game, the graphics looks pretty nice, like I said, very trippy. And another free stuff that's gonna come out in January, January proves to be month where free stuff likes to come out, is Eden Tomorrow demo. It's meant to come out in December, but sadly it's got delayed to January. Developers confirmed that it's definitely gonna be in January, the demo for this game. And Eden Tomorrow is a game when you go to like an alien planet, you got lost, you crashed, you're like, oh, well, where am I? I need to find out. And you're looking for people who crashed with you, but sadly they all kind of not alive anymore, because they decided to die for some strange reason. And what strange reason it is, it's for you to find out. So off you go to explore the planet and think, some weird shit gone down on this planet. Everyone is fucked and dead. I gonna go to the bottom of this situation. You're not by yourself, you got little robot helping you. He's your companion, and that's only two of you. Apparently from people who played the demo already on the various events, the game supposed to look beautiful and even beautifuler on PlayStation 4 Pro. So I'm definitely looking forward to download this demo. It's been in development for like a 4 years now, this game, so they definitely took their time. So when it drops, you can expect very nice polished game. And delayed from October to November, and then from November to December, and now from December to January, it's Sharknado VR, a game based on a franchise of movies which took world by the storm. Actually by the tornado mixed with shark. So this is basically a wave shooter. You still can move around small area and you're shooting shark that falling on you from the sky and trying to fall on your head and said, we're gonna eat you, but you like, not a chance, shark. You can shoot them, but also you can chop them in half with a chainsaw. Very, very nice. I hope it's gonna be as bad as movies, because that's gonna mean it's gonna be so bad that it's good. So looking forward to that. Okay, and last thing that it's 100% confirmed for January, it's 18 Floors DLC. So as you know, 18 Floors released for PSVR, people started playing it and then they realized, wait a minute, we passed 2 floors and there should be another 16 floors, but there ain't. There's only 2 floors in this 18 floor game. So what's happened is, many people didn't know this was scheduled as a release, segregated release, which means the floors will appear with time. So that's gonna be our first DLC. I'm not sure if that one is free or not. I'm sure they said first one will be free. So you're gonna have some more floors to explore. This is a puzzle game with some puzzles being really, really hard, but also very, very satisfying. So finally, some more floors. So yeah, we're getting closer and closer to this 18 floors, the numbers getting smaller. Eventually we're gonna get there and gonna get all 18 floors, probably in a year 2118. And that's it, bye.